I noticed there were a few not so dry eyes in the house right now. Nikki? Yeah? You don't have to talk about it, it's okay. Fine. So Sarah, while you're still standing, I'm gonna ask you to drag your lovely husband over here.
Yeah.
By whatever body part you feel necessary.
And not rip her dress.
Put your dress on my foot. To say a few words to your
speech all day. It's worse than actually getting married, so. Our speech today is like a mini skirt, long enough to cover the essentials, but short enough to hold your attention. To be honest, I didn't really know where to start, so I thought I'd trawl the internet, and after a couple hours I found some really, really good stuff. But then I remembered, I had to write a speech.
That's when the ministers came in.
Before I start, there will be plenty of toast over the next few minutes. I need a drink. So please make sure there's...
Your woman's got it, don't worry.
Yeah, thanks woman. Make sure your glasses are full. So lovely to see so many of our friends and families here today to help us celebrate the happiest days of our lives. I know some of you have traveled a long way to be here. It means a lot to us. Where are we? It really wouldn't be the same without you. It'd be a darn sight cheaper, but that's not the point. Thank you all for your generous gifts, and a special thank you to those who have given checks. No, really, we are grateful for those, especially as we will be using the details on the checks to set up a direct debit paying our bills for the years to come. Who said identity fraud isn't a bad idea?
Unfortunately, it's not been possible to have everyone we love here with us today, but we know they are here with us in spirit, and that they're not only in our thoughts today, but most importantly, they're here with us in our hearts, all the time. One particular life that was close to us was Connor's grandfather, Martin. As a tribute to his life and all the others close to our hearts that have passed on, we will be making a contribution to the McNally House here in Grimsby. In lieu of thank you gifts and the floral centerpieces, Connor's uncle David and Aunt Kelly have generously provided us with beautiful pumpkins displayed on our tables today and the fresh strawberries used in your strawberry cinnamon jam that each of you will be taking home tonight. The monetary amount that we saved on our centerpieces and gifts will be donated on everyone's behalf. So with Martin and my grandmother Violet in our mind, would you please raise your glasses and join me in toast to have some friends and family?
I'd like to sincerely thank Sarah's mother and father, Arthur and Tammy, for making me feel like the son they never wanted. Sorry. Right from day two. Day one was a bit rough. But I think we're over it now. Her sister as well, Marissa, you never made me feel more welcome, and I'd like to thank you for that. To my parents, Dave and Carol, who have helped me greatly over the years. seen me through thick and thin, mainly thick, if I'm being honest, but they could have been there for me, and I hope that I've done than Brown. I really couldn't have asked for better parents, and I'd like to thank you for everything that you've done, not just for me, but also for my wife and I. Thank you. To my grandma Jill, thank you for allowing us to use your beautiful home and get ready and take our photos there today. Thank you, Grandma.
There's an unwritten rule of wedding etiquette that states that nobody should look more handsome than the groom.
Sorry.
And I like.
Sorry.
I think we can all say that.
And I'd like to thank our groomsmen for sticking to that. All of your help has made us feel that we have some pretty rad friends.
I've known Matt, my best man, for nearly 8 years now, and throughout that time, he's been there for me when it matters, and is always ready when it encouraging words and a cold case of beer when things go badly. And if I'm being honest, when things are going well, I'd like to thank him for always being there and being a true friend. Apart from my wife, there are five other ladies here today. Beautiful ladies. I didn't want to say that, but I had to. I'd like to thank them, each and every single one of you, very much for being such a wonderful and supportive bridesmaids to my wife. So please join me in a toast to the bridesmaids. Finally, I would like to thank my wife. I think I'm going to enjoy getting used to that, saying that, for agreeing to marry me and for making me the happiest man in the world. I think you'll agree that she looks absolutely gorgeous today. And when she walked up the aisle, she took my breath away. We forgot the sign.
That's
why
you don't
need to
say that.
Sorry, I'm just making it easier. So they say you don't marry someone you can't live with. You marry someone who you can't marry with. Oh, no.
I know who wrote that speech.
Obviously, I didn't.
Correct.
You marry the person who you can't live without, and I think that sums up perfectly. Now if I had to single out one thing about why I love Sarah so much, it would be the fact that she makes me happier than I ever dreamed I could be. And I intend to spend the rest of my life making sure that the reverse is also true. I know that Sarah has put a huge amount of effort into making today perfect, and I think that she has done and more. Having lived with Sarah for a couple of years now, I have learned a valuable lesson. When I'm wrong, admit it. And when I'm right, keep quiet. Seriously though, I have never had a problem finding the words to express my love for Sarah. But if I start again, I won't be able to stop.
Who wrote that?
Needless to say, Sarah, I love you so much, and I can't wait to see how our future unfolds and grow old with you. But with that said, everyone in our wedding is meant to be, well, everyone says that our wedding is supposed to be meant to be the best day of your life, but now I know that isn't true. It's been the best day of my life so far, because I know that I have so many more amazing days to come. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and raise your glasses to my wife, Sarah.
Oh, by the way,
being beautiful isn't easy.
Cut into that beautiful cake over here.